So, what are some heart blockers? I'm just going to list them and tell you the highlights of them. Number one, the feelings first fallacy. The feelings first fallacy says, I've got to feel like changing first before I change. That is a lie. If you're waiting for your feelings to change, you're going to wait forever. Feelings will change after your will says, I'm going to do it, and you start walking that way. Feelings are great followers, but they're horrible leaders. Don't wait for them to change. Number two, here's another lie or deal breaker or heart blocker. It is waiting for breakthrough wishful thinking. Have you ever gotten stuck in that zone where you're like, man, I'm just waiting for breakthrough, and when it happens, then I'll change? Listen, this is your breakthrough. This is your moment. God has given you now. And he's saying, this is your invitation to change. You don't need some magical fire in the sky for you to say, man, this is my sign from God. It's happening right now. Stop waiting for some magical moment. It's here now. You are the breakthrough, by the way. God wants to change. The Spirit of God is pressing you to change because you know where you need to be and you long to be that person, and God wants that for you too. So feelings first fallacy, waiting for breakthrough wishful thinking. Number three, been there, done that. Past failure curse. Have you ever felt cursed? Like, oh, I've done it a million times before. What's the point of trying it again? Listen, you try again now. The Bible says that a righteous man falls seven times and gets back up. So just because you've failed a bazillion times before, God has given you new grace today. Don't let the past be a reason why you're not moving forward. Number four, the people-pleasing syndrome. You just want to change because you want everybody to get off your back. That is a bad motive to change. You change because God wants you to change. You change because you want to change. And lastly, and this is not what we're doing here, and it is a self-help program, a behavior modification. Like, if I just do certain things right, everything was going to be okay. Look, we're not about that here today. We believe with all our hearts that the Holy Spirit of God wants to change us. And when he does that work in us, we'll go from being stuck to being unstuck. And it starts when we start thinking rightly about the things that we're thinking about. So hey, how about it? Are you ready to jump in? The first step to change is think it. You become the person that God wants you to be when you start getting your thinking right.